I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you the overhanging beam containing UV, UDL and the point loads. Okay, the downward arrow considers positive, upward negative, sagging positive, hogging negative. Now first I will convert into a point load. Here. This is RA reaction, 14 kilonewton. Now it is UDL is 1.5 here, exactly at center, 1.5 into 6, this distance. The answer is 9 kilonewton. Similarly here, exactly at the center, 1.5 into 10. Answer is 15 kilonewton. And distance will be 5 meter, and this here distance will be 3 meter apart. Now reaction RC 2 meter, and the point load acting downward 6 kilonewton. A, B, C and D. Now we have to find out the reaction. Arrow is upward, minus RA, plus 9, plus 14, plus 15, minus RC, plus 6 is equal to 0, because vertical force, sum of the vertical force is equal to 0. Minus taken as common, RA plus RC is equal to, if you bring entire term this side, it becomes minus 44 kilonewton. This and this cancel, it becomes RA plus RC is equal to 44 kilonewton, equation 1. Now taking moment about A, we have to take moment about the A. Now moment about A, this becomes what? If it is clockwise, we have to consider negative, that is, this is the negative part, this will be clockwise, this will be anticlockwise. Okay, or sagging will occur. If the load is occur, hogging occurs. Therefore, consider minus 6 into distance. Minus 6 into distance. Distance will be 10, 16, 18. Plus RC into distance. Plus RC into distance will be 16. Next, minus 15 into distance. This distance, that is 6 plus 5, 11. Next, minus 14 into 6. Next, minus 3 into 3. Minus 9 into 3 is equal to 0. If you calculate, RC is equal to 16. Bring entire term this side, it becomes 24. If you bring this entire term this side, total, that means 6 into 16 plus 15 into 11. Plus 14 into 6 plus 9 into 3 divided by 16. Therefore, RC will be, if we divide this part, the RC will be 24 kilonewton. Now put RC in equation 1. The RC, RA is equal to 44 minus 24 is nothing but 20 kilonewton. We got RC value. RC value is 24 kilonewton. RA is nothing but 20 kilonewton. Now go for shear force. Now first I will consider the D. I will start from right side. There is a point load. I will consider right side. There is no load on right side. Zero. Left side, SFD. On left, it is 6 kilonewton. At C, again there is a point load. Consider right and left. FC, right side. Right side will be the previous value, 6 as it is. Now at left, SFC at left, 6 minus 24. Because upward arrow will be, I have to consider as negative. Upward arrow is considered as a negative here. negative. Answer will be minus 18. Now SF at B on right side, right side, the previous value minus 18 plus 15 minus 3. On left side, SFB on left minus 3 plus 14, minus 3 plus 14 is 11. Again at A, SF at A, there is a point load right side, the previous value 11 plus 9, 20. Now on left, left SFA on left, 20 minus 20 is equal to 0. Draw the bending, sorry, shear force diagram here. I'm drawing the shear force diagram. SFD above is positive, below is negative. First value is 0, 0, at A 0, there are 2 and 20. B, there are two values, 11 and minus 3. This is 11 minus 3. At C, 18 and 6. Minus 18, 6. At D, 6 and 0. Draw the lines. Because of UDL, it becomes inclined line. This will be positive, negative, positive. Now bending moment, we'll go for bending moment here. Bending moment, bending moment, bending moment at A, because it is a having a support, bending moment at A will be 0. If you calculate, then the value will be 0 here. Bending moment at B, bending moment at B will be 6 minus 6 into distance, that is 12, plus 24, plus 24 into 10, minus 15 into 5. Answer is 93 kilonewton meter. The bending moment at C, bending moment at C, minus 6 into 2, it will be minus 12 kilonewton meter. Bending moment at D will be 0. Bending moment at D will be 0. Now I am drawing the bending moment here. BMD, the positive and negative side. First is 0 and last is 0. The B value is 93 kilonewton meter. And C value is minus 12 kilonewton meter. Because it is a UDL, parabola comes in picture. UDL parabola comes in picture. There is no UDL, straight line. Now we have to find out the point of contraflexure here. Find out the point of contraflexure. This is the point of contraflexure. How to find out? No. I have to draw this part separately. If it is an inclined line or triangle, with by taking the x you can find out. But if it is a curve, then you have to separate this part. This part has to be separated. I will cut this part and rewrite here. Rewrite. The bottom value will be 24 kilonewton. This diagram you have to cut. Okay, don't use this diagram. You have to cut this diagram. UDL 1.5 kilonewton meter. There is a point load here, 6 kilonewton. A distance of 2 meter. This is the x for me. I have to find out the point of contraflexure. Convert into a point load. Convert into point load here. Converting into point load. 24 kilonewton. 6 kilonewton. 2 meter. Now here point load will be 1.5 x, this part will be x by 2, total length will be x here. Now I will consider g here, bending moment at g, or at a distance of x you can find out here what is the bending moment. Now 6 minus 6 minus 6 into 2 plus x minus 6 into 2 plus x, next plus 24 into x minus 1.5 x into x by 2, 24 x into x by 2 is equal to 0. Multiply this term, minus 6x minus 6x minus 12. Okay, first I have to write 12, but I have written 6x. Okay, 12 plus 24 x minus 1.5 x square divided by 2. Further, this can be written as minus 0.75 x square, this and this term, plus 18x minus 12 is equal to 0. With the help of the calculator, go for equation 3, minus 0.75, 18 minus 12. The x value will be 23.31 and 0.686. You have to select smaller value. Select smaller value. Now this error is nothing but 0.686. The distance of this part will be 0.686. If you measure total distance from this direction, it is 0.686 plus 2. 0.686 plus 2. Answer is 2.686. This is nothing but point of contraflexure. In this way, you have to solve the problem. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.